Switch off. We have to wait at and sit at half court before we can be subbed in. Teachers can sub in.
Fine, we can.
What?
Okay. I thought this
could be like, all 5 of us.
Yeah, we are.
Okay, so that's another matter.
But we have to sit. Don't. You can't.
Ian, what's your
right? We can't be subbed in.
Rip
circle.
All right.
Yeah.
Please on God, though. Please.
Half. Starting lineup. They know who they are.
Okay, here's what we're doing. We're going to do the first 10 non-starting first. We're going to have Peyton walking in first. Then Sean Peterson. Ethan Melton.
Woo!
Then Finn McBride. Come down again.
Wait, where's
go up this way. Go down this way.
Oh, where's this thing going down? Are we doing it?
I don't know.
Oh, wait. Yeah. Can you hold this?
Yeah. Yeah.
All right, let's get ready for this. Are you wide?
Thank you.
Please continue to bring in non-perishable items, and if you forgot some tonight, feel free to find me tomorrow, and I'll make sure I get this to the father next week.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Staffsketball. We're going to introduce your students first. We have Peyton Barish,
Sean Peterson.
There's Ethan Melton for you. Ben McBride's walking onto the court now.
You might recognize him from your favorite Lord of the Rings movie, looking a shameless way to the rim. It's 5'5" point guard, Ben McBride. 6'3".
Making his return to Green Hope is Ian Delgado. Oh, the one and only Ryan Kemper there. And there's Devin Vaughn for you guys.
And now it's time for the students' starting lineup.
And here's the starting lineup for the students. Oh, and you're looking at Camden Holbrook. Force to be reckoned with. Here comes Chris Inman. Oh, big body Mike Rowe there for you guys.
Is Mike Rowe. The coach's favorite award for this 5'8" point guard is Michelle Ramsey.
There's Michelle Ramsey.
5'8" shooting guard, soccer player for the Green Hopes team. It is Anna Bevan.
And there's Anna Bevan. And that's your Green Hope senior lineup. Now it's time for the staff and faculty lineup. The captain for the faculty, Colin Fagley. And there's Mr. Kesterson coming out.
This teacher's hoping you train on the team to drop buckets tonight. It's Dave.
There's Mr. Dave.
And the CT department goes along for making sure they say excuse me as he dribbles around the students. It's Salalaklu.
There's Mr. Salalaklu. Mr. S, as the students call him. There's the men's varsity soccer coach, Coach Corsby.
Won a national championship last year there, Tommy.
Yes, he did.
As the CT department, this teacher graduated from Southern New Hampshire with a degree of
There's Mr. Bald, one of the coaches for the Green Hope varsity football team. And there's Miss Ross.
The
There's Miss Hill.
Our softball coach here does a great job with the softball team.
Yes, she does.
It's Mr. Butler.
There's Mr. Butler. There's the Falcon Vision teacher himself, Mr. Adams. And now it's time for the starting lineup for the faculty. There's Coach Denton, one of the PE teachers here at Green Hope.
He's a JV girls varsity coach, too. I think he's 7'1", looks like. Maybe 7'2".
Definitely going to be hard to guard for the students.
He's going to be big inside, man.
There's Mr. Mariola.
They just won a track state championship.
Yeah,
cross
our
country.
Cross country coach and our varsity baseball coach.
Yes.
There's Mr. Bald again.
Coach Ball, he's in the Hall of Fame of his elementary school, doing a great job.
Yeah. Where's one of the English teachers, Miss Moakley? There's Miss Lasco.
She coaches our girls JV softball team and basketball.
She should be one of the better players on the faculty team.
Yeah. Athletic. Hopefully got a lot of hustle in her. Okay.
Once again, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name's Thomas Cassie. I'm joined alongside tonight by Coach Sawyer. We have a great game for you tonight. Mr. Sawyer's going to take you through what we should be looking for.
Well, I appreciate that. Hopefully we're looking for an exciting game. Both of these teams have battled through the national playoffs. Green Hope's staff, they came through, won in double overtime last week to get here. The students, they've had a little easier road. They actually won in single overtime. So both teams have been very good on the way. This has been a six-month endeavor, workouts, practices, a lot of hard work to get to this point. This
yes.
should be exciting. Hopefully, it looks like the I would say the students looking to run a little bit. Got some track, cross country guys on there. Maybe the staff is maybe looking to slow it down a little bit, Thomas.
You know, I wouldn't be surprised if the students will outrun the faculty. They are a bit younger, a bit more agile, younger bones, obviously.
This game's ready to tip off. This should be exciting. Welcome aboard, fans.
Here we go. Looks like Coach Denton and Camden Holbrook with the tip-off, and the faculty will win it.
Coach Ball brought it up, known for his drive into the bucket.
And that was good defense by the Green Hope seniors to tip the ball out of bounds.
We can see right off the bat what the faculty's game plan is.
They are.
Get it into the big man.
Absolutely. They definitely have height advantage over all the seniors. As Mariola with the little fader. There's Lasco, hands it off to Denton. Mariola with the three.
Downtown Raleigh. Oh, what a shot.
And great rebound by Mike Rowe. That was good ball movement by the faculty. Was not expecting that right off the bat.
Looks like the faculty's setting up in a 2-3 zone. Let's see what the students can come up with, type of offense they're going to run. A little backdoor action.
Oh! They went for a little alley-oop layup.
That was great.
But Denton said no way and shut that down quickly.
They pulled that off in the semifinals with a dunk to tie the game last week.
Here goes Chris Emmon with the three, and it's good.
tell you what, that was downtown Raleigh there.
There was no question that I was going in, nothing but net.
Almost in a different time zone.
And good steal from Anna Bevan. And travel's called against her.
It looks like the staff may be a little tight right now. They'll loosen up, hopefully, as the game goes on.
Lasco with the ball. Passes it out to Mariola. Looks to drive, a little fair. And it's a good!
Nice little jump shot from about 10 feet out.
Mariola is one of the better players on the faculty. He did coach when at his old high school in Maine. Also played a bit in his high school and elementary school days.
Oh, that was clean. That was clean.
Great defensive play from Denton.
Faculty trying to get out and run a little bit.
It was a good counter attack attempt, but it just did not fan out for them.
You can tell Mariola's played some ball somewhere. Maybe D1 somewhere.
The seniors are working around the perimeter. Holbrook with the shot, easily rebounded by the staff.
Let's see if the staff can get it inside to the big man. Oh, it looked like, oh. Good inside play there, but just can't put the ball in the bucket.
You can definitely see the staff have come to play. Might give the seniors a bit of a run for their money.
Yeah. Right now, it's anybody's game. He looked to maybe put it up.
Balled with the shot, rebounded by Holbrook.
Oh, off his foot, off his foot. Let's see if the staff has any inbounds plays they can run here for a quick hitter. That would be nice.
Looks like Denton will be taking the with the pass in. Questioning that, you know, you have a big man like that, you might want him. And the paint.
That was set up by the pass from out of bounds. That was a pre-designed play. You could tell that they worked on it.
Well done.
Oh, that had to be.
Oh, and a travel call against the seniors. Very questionable.
Yeah.
I did not think that was a travel. But I am no referee.
Yeah, well, you know what? We got to go with it right now. He did kind of maybe take that pre-step.
Yeah. Hey, put it up. Come on.
And it looks like the seniors have made an early substitution.
Can you give them a technical?
And Mr. Reese, the referee, call it technical.
Yeah.
Against the seniors. You know, there might be a little bit of collusion going on early in the game.
Well, we don't want to use that word collusion, but yeah, it could be. I saw some money maybe passed to his way earlier in before warm-ups, but we're not gonna speculate because
nope.
We don't have any hard facts, but
the seniors might be in for a long game.
Well, and right now, the faculty have come out with a lot of intensity. I like what I'm seeing.
And the faculty have made a substitution also.
Thomas, let's talk about this crowd. It's pretty intense.
You know, it's almost a full house on this side.
I don't think there's an empty seat in here. So if you're not here, you're missing a heck of a game.
No, it is 4-3. This faculty currently leading has all of us by surprise.
Hey.
And that was Adams on the drive. But the ball did get away from him. It's Finn McBride bringing the ball up the court. Looks like the seniors put in their cross-country lineup.
Uh-oh. Looks like an errant pass. It looks like Adams came dressed to play outside. Somebody forgot to tell him it's inside.
That was Bearish with the fake shot.
Oh, good rebound.
Rebound by Adams. You know, the seniors have not contested many rebounds from the faculty.
Right now, the faculty's controlling the boards. Adams is open down there. Nobody sees him.
That was Ross with the shot. And it was a brick. But Sean Peterson driving hard. Little Euro step.
That'd be a charge.
Oh, and it was a charging foul called against Sean Peterson.
Oh, he looked good taking it to the bucket, but if he got to pull up. And
I really wanted to see if her feet were set.
Yeah, let's look at the instant replay. You know what? She was set. I thought she was a statue the way she was set.
Oh, good pass there from Miss Hill. And I don't even...
That had to be a pass.
I think Mr. Adams was trying to shoot to space or something.
Let's
I mean,
call it a pass. Yeah. It had to be a pass.
Well, let's put that out on stat sheet.
Yeah, we're not going to call that a shot.
And there's Corsby. Nice pass to Hill. Little 1-2.
Oh, that could
good
go.
Shot. Oh.
Okay. That's a long two.
Ooh, and it fell short. Here comes Hill on the breakaway. Goes up the layup and gets fouled. Payne Bears with the foul there.
It looks like she's going to go through the line, Thomas. Shoot two. Right now, I would say the faculty have come out playing pretty intense.
I think the seniors are sleeping on them a bit, you know.
What we got to look at is as this game progresses, will the faculty get tired?
Maybe the students are going for the long run instead of coming out hard, conserving their energy for the second half.
It is a long game. It's a long game.
Yes. Hill made her first free throw, stepping up to make her second. And good rebound from Delgado.
Now, he was he played on the JV squad when he was a 10th grader.
Good rebound. And it looks like it'll go out against the seniors. Nothing is just going for them, let me tell you.
Right now, everything's going the faculty's way.
A great steal from Peterson. Made up for that last miscombobulated dribble. I think the seniors need to work the ball around the perimeter a little more to get open. They're taking the long three-point shot, and it's just not falling for them yet.
Other than the initial three-pointer, that's the total offense right now. You're right. I think if they could maybe get it inside a little bit, maybe try to draw some fouls or something.
Don't know where Dave was trying to pass that ball to. You know, he did go to UNC, so you think he would have a bit of UNC talent.
He saw somebody in the stands he knew.
That could be it.
Now, this could be something. Ian can dunk.
He goes gets rejected by the rim. Good block there from Fagley. No, he was an athlete in his day.
He was. He really was.
An athlete here at Green Oak High School.
He played here. He was a star here. That was a Wilt Chamberlain type hook shot. Uh-oh. He's going, Right now, it's a lot of up and down. This could get ugly here.
Throws it out wide to Peyton. Goes up for the short jumper. And that was Sean Peterson using his height against Miss Hill.
One thing I've noticed, both teams playing extremely good defense.
This is
the intensity.
Yes. And a nice three there from Finn McBride.
Beautiful three. He squared up. He took a shot.
And that will give the seniors the go-ahead lead. Adams with the long three. And gets his own rebound. Puts it back in. That was one heck of a play.
That was tremendous. Tremendous play by Adams to be able to take the shot, follow it in, and get his rebound. If he's going to play like that tonight, the student's going to have to box out.
Oh. And that's the end of the first quarter. Your staff leads 7-6.
Thomas, tremendous, tremendous first quarter. Both teams played lights out. I don't think you're going to get a better faculty staff national championship game than what you're seeing right now.
You are right. You know, the offense have room to grow, but you still have three quarters left. The defensive, both sides of the Both teams pretty solid.
Solid defense. I think both of these teams have been known by about their lockdown defense and the intensity they play with.
And it looks like the faculty cheerleaders are doing some stunts. That is impressive from them.
Yeah. Well, most of those faculty cheerleaders were all state cheerleaders back in their day. Okay.
Now they are getting this crowd pumped up.
I'm not sure if we can hold another person on this side.
You know, I might have to stand up. It's so crowded over here.
Okay.
What a turnout for this national championship game. And we're back underway here for the second quarter.
Oh, he tried to go behind his back.
Here goes Devin. Devin Vaughn.
Adams is kind of controlling the boards right now while he's in there.
No, he's using his size and body well. And a double dribble call against Aaron Boone. The student section here is not happy with that call.
Yeah, it was a lot of displeasure there. Uh-oh, she got behind. Oh, okay.
Oh,
I thought she might take that in for a dunk. But
that was a nice pass there from Mr. S.
Yes, it was. Oh.
Oh, what a block from Devin Vaughn.
I think she feels she was hammered.
And a nice layup from Aaron Boone.
Beautiful layup. She took it strong to the rack. That was beautiful. Textbook. Wow. Okay.
And a nice little jumper there.
Aaron Boone's come in giving him a spark.
Oh, here comes Sky McKinnon. She does not know what to do with it. Definitely a travel.
Travel. Oh, my goodness. She had her bags packed on that one, man.
I think she might have been trying to go to Hawaii or something.
She was in the airport. Okay. But look, give her credit. She brought the ball down. She was getting ready to attack the bucket.
She had her eyes set up there. She,
oh, beautiful.
Feet got too much. Too happy.
In a tense game like this, it's easy to make a mistake. Everything's on the line for this national championship game.
And Hill with the jumper. And here comes Ethan Melton. You know, he's a football star, not really basketball, as you can see.
Well, he did try to get to the bucket, just didn't take the ball with him. That's a key.
That is nice crossover there from Mariola, but that is an air ball.
Well, let's call it a pass to Lasco. That had to be a pass. That was sort of remnants of 1983. Derek Wittenberg passed to Lorenzo Charles to win the national championship. If she'd have just called it and dunked it, that'd have been beautiful.
She did get fouled there, so she will be shooting two.
So close.
And you see they have Miss Hill here in the back, the faculty do, to stop that breakaway attempt.
She's a rim protector. She can definitely get up. She has a pretty good vertical. She can definitely get up.
And a nice free throw there from Miss Losco.
They look like they're trying, okay. Nothing but air on that one. They did get backboard.
Nice pass there from Miss Hill. Corsi breaking ankles.
What's the call down there? Is that a shooting foul or was it?
You know, I don't think it was a shooting foul. It looked like Corsi was trying to pass the ball there. And a foul called against. Looks like Ryan Kemper.
She's shooting too.
Seems like this. All the students can do is foul Miss Losco. She's just too good for them.
They definitely fouling right now. A couple of them been a mugging out there. If the faculty could make their free throws, they might be up at this point.
And here comes Ryan Kemper down the court for the seniors. And a nice three from Devin.
Devin had a nice stroke there, beautiful shot, squared up.
Who said big man can't shoot?
Oh, that big man can shoot.
And Denton tried to play a nice little pass in there. Easily scooped up by Ethan, who goes for another three, and it will not fall.
Right now, the faculty can't get a rebound. Uh-oh, got him for 3 seconds. Mm. He definitely had a campfire down there. He'd been camped down there so long, he'd put up a tent.
Well, it looks like Ethan's going to be full court pressure, Mr. Corsby.
We haven't seen pressure all game. That could be the difference.
Oh. Nice little pass and a reverse layup. That was beautiful.
Textbook. You can tell they've used that play over and over.
And it works every time.
Every time.
I don't think it can be stopped.
It's hard to stop the big man inside like that.
Oh, here comes Mr. Corsby. And Mariola with the putback.
It looks like the faculty's trying to get out and run a little bit.
So they've made a one-point game now.
Yep.
Seniors currently lead 13-12. And the seniors will be making a substitution, putting back in their starting lineup.
Faculty continues to stay in that 2-3, pack it back. Students going to have to continue to hit some shots, I think, unless they can get someone that can work inside around the paint.
Yeah. And they're going to have to watch those fouls. The fouls are killing them.
We could get some of the students in. Uh-oh. One of the faculty,
Coach. Miss Wall.
Yeah, she just did about, I think it was like 14
backhand
spring flips.
That was impressive.
I'd have done one and been out. This crowd really enjoyed that. That was a great, let's see what the students can do if they can try to get out and run a little bit, make the faculty chase.
And Chris Emmett will be bringing the ball up for the seniors. Good ball movement. And not even really close.
Well, yeah, I think she might have been looking for somebody inside. It just had the wrong jersey on.
A long three from Mariola. Good rebound from the big body, Mike Rowe.
He hit the initial three, and it looks like he thought he had another one.
It was looking good up to the point where it hit the rim.
Yeah. Not a lot of movement right now in the faculty. Offense is kind of stagnant. Oh.
And Corsi will step out of bounds there. He's not liking the call.
Could have been a push. I will say it's been pretty fair call.
In this quarter, yes. Good ball movement from the seniors. Mariel has a no-fly zone there.
Yeah.
Nothing's getting through.
Oh, he used his, he muscled
Denton
in.
Just,
he muscled in. He got fouled, he thinks.
There's no way Chris Inman's stopping Coach Denton.
I think the faculty's got to do more of that, get it into the big man, let him work inside a little bit.
All right. Works every time. Looks like the last time.
That was beautiful. Give and go. Okay, a little backdoor screen.
Nice little reverse layup to end it.
Exactly. You can tell Mariola and Coach Denton, they played a lot of ball together. You can tell they're working it inside out.
The chemistry is there. Here comes Chris.
Uh-oh.
And it looks like a
double dribble.
Double dribble will be called. Unfortunate for the seniors. That was going to probably be a scoring play for them. And staff still hold on to a one-point lead. Great pass from Denton.
Oh.
And Figley just got bodied by Chris Inman.
He got trucked is what happened.
Seniors look like they're only going to be shooting the three tonight.
I'd like to see the students try to take it inside a little bit.
No, it could be a strategic play on their part because the faculty do have height and size advantage on them.
Maybe they have been known to hit a lot of threes through the course of the tournament getting to this championship game. I think they were shooting an amazing 73% from three-point line. Coach S took a nice shot there. Little 10-footer from the short corner area.
Oh, where's your travel?
Oh, good ball movement there from the three seniors. Long three.
Okay.
I think that was closer to the other basket, to be honest with you.
Yeah, I'm not sure if he was looking at the rim or looking to pass, but...
That was nowhere near going in.
No, but you know what? Just keep shooting. Can't score if you don't shoot.
Faye wide open.
Oh, they're going to call goaltending.
That is unfortunate.
Yeah, I'm not sure if that ball would have gone in if he hadn't tapped the rim.
And... Ian Delgado checks in for Anna Bevan for the seniors.
The students have a couple high flyers out there that can get up above the rim. Let's see if they try to maybe change it up a little bit.
Oh, my goodness. Coach Denton just easily scooped that ball up.
He is just a man among boys in that paint right now.
I must say, Denton's passing is amazing right now.
Oh, that was
and
beautiful.
A great alley-oop way up there by the seniors.
Textbook. Well, that's what the students are known for. They're good out on the break. Somebody's got to come back and hope Coach S.
And no one is on Losco there. Will they give it to her?
They're going
to
count that.
Might have been after the buzzer, but...
We're going to have to go back and look at the shot clock. I'm not sure if she got that off before the buzzer.
And it looks like Mr. Reese, the ref, will be giving it to the faculty. That increases their lead to 18-15.
18-15 here at half. Thomas, what do you think? I mean, it looks like it's, like I say, it's everything we thought it would be. We knew the faculty and staff would come in here and it'd be a fist fight the whole game. It'd be a good battle. Both teams playing very hard. I'm going to be honest with you. The staff is playing a little better than expected right now.
Oh, absolutely. You know, one of the we will be right back at the start of the second half, folks. See you then.
Yeah, I can check.
Check.
What? That's the official ruling. And we're back at the start of the second half. That last shot did count. Apparently they started the clock a little too early before the ball was inbounded. So they were going to give it to him.
So that's, you know what? That's things happen like that in a national championship game. Both teams have played extremely well.
It is a tight game so far.
I would look for the students maybe to put a little more pressure on the ball this second half.
You know, the staff could be getting a little tired.
Exactly.
And a good take and one from Mr. Adams.
What a way to start the half. I mean, Adams took that straight strong to the rack.
Let's see if he can make the free throw, and he does.
Great start for the faculty right off the half. You couldn't draw it up better at halftime. I know they were talking about that.
Definitely caught the seniors off guard. Good inside pass the ball, and it goes in.
Right now, the faculty's come out with some intensity. Let's see if the students can try to match this the second half.
Seems like the seniors are still on the bench. They're not showing up right now.
Right now, they just got to hope the lead doesn't get too far. Keep this game close.
It is an 8-point game.
They are, as I anticipated, the students are putting a little press on.
They just cannot get a shot to sink right now.
Could be a lid on that rim down there.
You might want to get that checked out.
Yeah, faculty have the power to do that. Put a little lid on top of that rim up there.
Davi with the pass to Moakley. Throws it out to Mr. Adams with the jumper. And it will not fall.
Adams was open. He squared up, took a good shot.
Payne Barish with a nice three, and it's a air ball.
Must have been a pass. Had to be a pass. Students need something good to happen here on this possession. That's
good,
not what they were asking for.
Good steal from Dave. That's the type of players UNC looks for right there.
Oh, yeah. You know what? I know. I think Roy Williams is in the stands tonight. Okay, we got a timeout here.
Looks like both teams will be making substitutions.
I noticed we have a lot of legendary coaches in the stands tonight watching this game. It's been exciting. I think everyone has got their money's worth.
Yep. There's the staff cheerleaders.
That's hours and hours of hard work there.
Yes, it is. And the teams will take the court again.
I'm not sure where the students' cheerleaders are tonight, but maybe since they do have a great fan base here, they can try to get them pumped up. The students need a run here. They need to try to cut the lead here. Little backcourt pressure. Oh, no.
And a push called against Peyton Barish.
I think that could have gone either way, Thomas.
That could have been a backcourt violation, too.
Could have been. Probably should have been called.
All right, great steal from Peyton. Goes for the layup and just cannot sink it. But Aaron Boone with the rebound. Adams, SWAT team over here.
Monster block.
She's driving again. Another great block from Mr. Adams. And Finn McBride is there to finish it off.
Beautiful. Great block by Adams, but you know, you got to have people following the shot. That may get the students rolling here.
It's Coach Bull driving down. And the shot will get blocked.
There again, the faculty seem to be controlling the boards at this time. Oh.
Here goes Sean Peterson. Nice fake.
Looks like it's going to be a travel. Travel call. Adams, who was that? Somebody went for the block, caused him to shuffle his feet.
Unfortunate for the seniors.
Unfortunate. Right now, I think the students have got to put some kind of pressure on the ball.
And that foul will be called against Payne Bearsh. It is a shooting foul. Roscoe will go to the line again.
Right now, this could add to the lead.
Looking at the staff bench, it looks like they are very tired.
Yeah, conditioning is going to be an issue here down the stretch, I think.
And it looks like the seniors are getting ready to make a substitution after this. Good rebound from Payton. Fast break up the court. Good pass to Ryan. A nice floater from Sean P. It will not fall.
No second shots here. Oh.
And the ball will take a deflection off Sean Peterson for a staff.
Let's see if the staff has any inbound plays here. Quick headers off the. Oh, looks like, okay, got some subs coming in.
Some major height coming in for the seniors.
Got Ian and Devin coming in.
There's Quersby. And great rebound from Devin Vaughn.
Great defense, great rebound. That's what Ian was known for back in the day, but looks like he got hammered.
And the refs will not call it. And one for Devin Vaughn.
That's just being intense there in the paint. He played like a man down there, getting physical. Put back.
They finally got that foul called in their favor. Let's see if they can capitalize on it. He got his own rebound off that free throw. That's impressive.
Absolutely.
Caught the staff sleeping, it looks like.
Devin's come in and made a great impression on the game.
Shallow three. Put back by Ethan, and it falls.
Right now, the students are taking over the paint. Looks like they're putting a little full court pressure on. Miss Hill broke it, coming down.
Good pass to Faye, but Delgado with the easy steal. It's a 2v1 situation.
Oh, good defense, good defense.
Nice Euro step. It will not fall. Here comes Hill. Will she get to it?
Good hustle by Miss Hill. Just a little long on the pass.
It is a two-point game. And Coach Denton checks back in. Looks like the staff needed some height. Nice three there from Devin Vaughn.
Beautiful, beautiful shot. Right now, he's kind of taking over the game himself.
He just stared at Mario. That was great.
Good intensity. That's what I like, though. They slap hands. good sportsmanship right there. That's what we're paid for. That's what people, the ticket holders, wanted to see tonight.
Students have taken the lead. But not for long. Oh! Coach S's shot will not fall. It goes for the three. And it's rebounded by Devin Vaughn. Great steal from Denton with the reverse. Gets his own rebound. Another reverse and it falls. No chance.
I tell you what, you can see why he was All-American. You can see why he was picked as one of the best big men in the nation in this tournament. He's All-Tournament team. If that had gone, that place would have lit up.
And the students are cheering air ball against their own player. That is shocking.
Yeah, you don't see that often, but that could be another wake-up call for the students. Looks like they're going to a...
Denton with the three. We'll get his own rebound.
So close. Okay. Right now, both teams look like they're playing with some urgency.
And a nice three from Delgado. Beautiful. That's what we know from him.
Yes. Look, he has a total game. He can go inside or out. That's what you worry about defensively with him.
Good rebound from Losco. Gets double teamed by two seniors.
Very courageous to go up. She went up against two giants in there.
Saturday day, the smallest person on the court gets the rebound.
Exactly. She's wide open, squares up, nice shot. Ooh, close.
Good rebound from Devin. Here comes Delgado driving in. Good inside pass to Ethan. Amy Zane, the volleyball superstar. Her shot will not fall. Three-second violation there from the seniors.
Yeah. There again, he was illegally parked for a day.
Good defense from Ian.
Oh, great defense. Nobody steals a ball from Butler.
Good little no-look pass to Ethan, but he was not ready for it.
Ian might want to just do what he does.
Good rebound from Devin. We'll kick it out to Delgado. Shot falls short. And here comes Dennis. You know, Ian and Devin together on defense is a force to be reckoned
with.
Tremendous.
They were voted on the all-defensive team.
A
good pull-up, though. A good pull-up. He squared up. This could be trouble.
Good pass.
Oh, nice.
Easy.
Nice outlet pass. Beautiful.
Easy money. Seniors are starting to run away with it.
Right now, I think the faculty, they're going to be good to get this break here. This could be
Here's
big.
The three. Oh, went for the bank shot.
Adams.
There it is. Adams and Denton in the paint. Unstoppable.
Very. They may have to ride that horse all the way to the end of the game.
And Adams with the full court shot, not even close. That draws an end to the third quarter here at Green Oak High School. Your seniors with the lead 29-27. We'll be back at the start of the fourth and final quarter.
And we're back here at the start of the fourth and final quarter. Seniors have a two-point lead over the faculty.
This has been everything we thought it would be. It's been clean. It's been played with a lot of sportsmanship, a lot of energy.
The fans have been electric tonight.
I haven't seen a crowd like this in years.
Good shot from Anna.
Oh,
what a way to come out.
Wow. Just you can tell they drew that up in the timeout there.
She might be our secret weapon for the seniors. And Dave with a shot. That's the UNC in him right there.
I tell you what, both teams have come out fired up. They know what's on the line.
You know, I heard from a source that Dave actually had one-on-one training with Roy Williams.
Oh, wow.
To work on that jumper for tonight's game.
I believe it. They said he's been at the Dean Dome shooting for weeks for this game.
Dave's calling for it. He wants another shot. But Adams tried to drive. Here comes Cannon Holbert with the dunk.
He made dunk.
Oh, my goodness.
What a dunk. Monster.
Wow.
Monster dunk. That could be something to really ignite the fans.
You know, that could be a SportsCenter top 10 play.
Oh, we got a charge on Adams. The faculty may need a timeout here.
No, the game is running away from them. It's a four-point game, two possessions. Not really a lot to worry about right now.
No shot clock. That dunk was just magnificent. He brought it from downtown Raleigh. It was a tomahawk like most people have seen in years.
I would not be surprised if that's number two or three on the SportsCenter top 10 post.
ESPN, absolutely. That may be on the top 10 for the year.
I would not be surprised at all. Looks like the seniors are just passing it around now. And a shooting foul called against the faculty. Looks like it's all in their favor now.
The faculty have been very clean on not fouling all night. That could have been one of the first fouls called. That's a shooting foul. He should be shooting too. This is danger time right now for the faculty.
Oh, Camden tried for the reverse, could not get it.
Nice move, just didn't finish. Running a little weave action here.
Nice move from Mariola. That was amazing.
Nice smooth stroke, beautiful shot. That was a preset play off the coming down on that, you could see that. Little weave action with some back door for Mariota. Did we get a timeout before the tie-up? That's just great coaching over there.
Well done by the student coaches. They called the timeout.
Yeah, it looks like we've got Schaffer over there coaching and Lawson for the students. Both of them are big-time varsity players, playing very well this year. Let's talk about the varsity squad a second. They got a great team.
They do. You know, it'll be interesting how they do in playoffs and in the rest of the season.
Yeah. There is talk that whoever wins this game here, may play them in a game.
You know, that'd be a great game to watch.
I'm not sure who I'd put my money on, but I would say the winner of this squad would give the varsity a great game.
A run for their money, most definitely.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
You know, Panther Creek's coming up. That's going to be a big fight for 55 points there. Our Green Up does have a pretty comfortable lead in that, I must say.
Yeah, I think we're dominating the fight for 55.
There's really no competition, I think, so far.
Well, we're what, 7-8 years Wells Fargo Cup winner?
I mean,
how could we battle with one school?
True.
I mean, we're beating everybody else in the whole state.
It's no competition.
No. But you know what? Panther Creek's a great school down there.
Yeah.
Got to give them good kudos.
It will be a good game nonetheless. It always is.
Panther Creek is very good. They have a great basketball squad down there. So let's see what the faculty come up with. Right now they're back into that 2-3.
It is a one possession game. Anna Bevan tried for that same three. Went a little, she's a little too strong, went over.
Yeah. Maybe the adrenaline's going right now.
Here goes Chris Simon. Good fake shot by Mike. Shallow shot. And rebound by Michelle. But Mr. Adams just puts his hands up.
She rebounds so well. She rebounds with heart. She's always in the right place for that rebound.
Always in the right place at the right time.
Okay, 5 minutes to go in this game. Students up by three.
It can easily turn just like that.
One possession away from a tie. Coach S is he can score from anywhere. A little referee's help there, but that's okay.
It happens. And the students will be making substitutions.
Looks like both teams are trying to get key players in. Oh, nice entry pass.
Dave plays it back out. Oh, good movement. Might have been some fouling there, not sure.
Yeah.
Refs seem to let it play.
They're letting them play right now. This game don't want to be decided by referees' calls. Adams doing a little too much dribbling down there.
Oh, good ball from Finn McBride. Play it to Peyton.
Oh, what a shot.
Easy finish. That was amazing.
Costly turnover right there. Beautiful shot.
Increases the seniors' lead to five. Another jumper from Coach Dennis. Does not fall for him, though.
He's used to playing soccer. He played at State, North Carolina soccer, back in the day.
Oh. What a shot from Sky McKinnon.
Wow.
Really. That is an 8-point game now. Seniors are running away from it.
Right now we need a timeout for the faculty.
And it looks like they will call a timeout. Just now, electric now. It is.
Oh, this crowd is at a fever's pitch. Now, I think the faculty have to go with what they can do best, get it inside. Maybe try to get people in foul trouble, get some easy points off of fouls if you're students. What do you think? What do you think they got to do there, Thomas?
No, I think they need to start playing better defense, start shutting down passes, maybe go to a zone defense, maybe man-to-man if they're feeling a little risky. They need to start playing a little more safe basketball.
Exactly. What I wouldn't do is relax if I'm the students.
Oh,
I would definitely put maybe some full court pressure because the faculty have shown they're not as good on the press right now. Faculty staff doing what they do well. Nice little pyramid there. Looks like the staff has gone to their
all-star lineup.
Yes. They got a lot of big players in there.
Jumper from Corsby.
That looked good.
Rebounded out to Coach Denton. Adams with the three.
Right now, the staff's controlling the boards.
They are definitely using their height. And shooting. I think that might have been a shooting foul called against Sky McKinnon of the seniors.
Two shots. They could get it down to six here. That'd be big.
That's going to hurt them.
Need to try to get one here if you're the if your staff, maybe try to throw on a little full court press if possible.
Would not be surprised if we see a lot more heavy pressure from the staff. They have their biggest guys in right now. They need to start using their height. Ball bounced around the rim there, but did not fall.
There is no shot clock, so if you're the students,
just pass around the faculty.
Work it around, take some time off the clock. Maybe go to an old Carolina four corners.
And a travel call against Sean Peterson.
That's costly. That's costly.
This late in the game, this close, really. Here comes Adams.
That three could be big.
Okay. Does not fall right.
Had to take it. She was open. She's known to hit those threes. Students, they might need a timeout to set up their press where they want to stall a little bit.
Great shot from Mario.
Beautiful.
Right over the hands of who?
It up.
That was Ian Delgado.
That was big right there. That was big.
That cuts it down to a 5-point game. Students need to do something to break up this string of good luck for the staff. Another three from Mariola.
Looked good when it left his hands.
Here's the full court press we were talking about earlier from the faculty.
Yeah, they used it last week and it worked extremely well. Now, I don't...
Oh, great pass from Denton to Mariola.
We can set it up if we're the staff. Set it up, run some plays. That was good defense, good defense.
About a minute 45 left here in the fourth quarter. Good rebound from the... Oh, my goodness. Coach Denton just really hammered that down. Here comes Mariola to Adams. And he will get fouled for two.
If Adams could have scored that and got the free throw, that would have cut it to two right there. But give Adams credit to stay with it.
Yes. He is a very good free throw shooter, so.
I think at his elementary school, he set a record for most free throws in a row.
No, I think you're right. I think he still holds it to this day.
Oh, yes. Let's see if he can give the faculty one. Give him one.
Good rebound there by Camden. It's a 4v2.
Smart move. Pull it back out. Eat some time up.
Floater from Sean Peterson's good.
That was a good shot. That was a high-pressure shot.
7-point lead now for the students. Students are heckling the staff. In a 4v1 situation.
They come with a dunk.
Oh, they tried for
they
it.
Should have took it out, ate up some time.
Here's Lasco.
Oh, she was hammered. She was hammered. That was almost illegal what happened there.
Not good defense by the students there. They do make subs with 48.6 seconds left.
If she could get both of these, cut it down to five, call a timeout, set up a press, maybe get a steal. That's okay. That's all right. Maybe she can give the faculty this one. Nice tip out.
No one's there to pick that up.
That was a smart play. It just didn't work.
Good reverse layup from Devin.
That could put the nail in the coffin right there. That could be all she wrote.
9-point lead, 30 seconds left. Shots need to start falling for the faculty if they're going to want to win this game.
The rim was not kind because that thing went in and out. That ball went everywhere but down.
Yeah. Students call a timeout. About 30 seconds left here in the game. Students have a 9-point lead.
Yeah, let's not give up, but I don't think I've ever seen a team come back quite like this with 28.6. Obviously, the students being undefeated as they have through the national tournament, ranked number one, obviously, in their division.
Right.
It's going to be hard for them to give up a lead up by nine here. If the faculty could get a couple steals and three-pointers, anything's possible. But it's been very competitive.
It has been.
Both teams have played their hearts out. Great sportsmanship.
If I was the faculty, I would not be mad with this outcome.
No, the faculty have represented themselves very well.
They were the underdogs going into this. They were not projected to make it to the finals of this tournament, and yet they proved people wrong.
Well, had a couple key players not playing tonight for the faculty due to injuries. That's a beautiful shot there, right there.
That could be it right there.
That could be it. She had a beautiful shot. You could tell her skills. She's trained a lot in basketball.
Here, Michelle. She's going down again. And that's it, folks. Students win 46-35. It's been one great game.
Both teams played well. A lot of good play from the players. Everyone played excellent out there. Great sportsmanship. A lot of the fans, like I say, as you said, I don't think there was a seat in this gymnasium.
You are right. All right. Thank you for joining us tonight, folks. See you next time. Good night.